All right, now that the dog has learned the sit and down behaviors, we're going to start teaching him the other reason why he needs to do these behaviors. So it's fine to lure your dog into either sit or down, but after a while they have to learn to pay attention to the command, and they have to stop responding just to the food. So while I'm still using the food lure, I'm going to introduce him to collar pressure, which I use as a negative reinforcer to basically tell the dog, whatever I tell you to do next, that's what's going to make you comfortable. Now when I talk about collar pressure, I'm really talking about a sensation. So all I'm doing is applying a very small amount, not enough to move him. I want the dog to move, but this is more annoying than no pressure. So I apply pressure first, then give the command and use the lure, and as soon as he hits the ground, then the pressure goes away, he gets praised, and the reward is delivered. So it will be like this. Pressure, sit. Good boy, yes, that's right. Excellent, dismissed. Good. Sit, yes, excellent, very good. Now I'm exaggerating loosening the pressure because I want to make sure that you see how quickly it happens in response to him hitting the sit. But mainly it just needs to go away. Now you can see he's already anticipating. Okay, dismissed. So when the dog says, all right, I get it, we're working on the SIT word, then you start changing the timing. So now I'm going to say the word and apply the pressure at the same time. Sit. Yes, good boy, that's right. Okay, dismissed, ready? Sit, yes, excellent dog. Very good, okay, one more time, ready? Sit, excellent. And what we get is speedier response after a while. Okay, then we're going to apply the same principle to the down. And again, I'm gonna get on the dog's level. And I'm going to give him every cue that he already knows, but I'm also going to apply collar pressure with my left hand on the leash right underneath him. You're cheating. Now sit up. Good boy. Wait. Good. So I'm going to do pressure, down, down. Excellent. And as he hits the ground, the pressure goes away and he gets rewarded. Okay, good job. Let's try again. Sit. Nice work. Good boy. Down. Good boy. That's right. Excellent dog. Very good. And as he gets speedier with that, then what I'm going to do is hold the signal up and wait for him to complete the down. So I'm going to do pressure, down, yes, good boy, that's right. Excellent, okay, you did it easy, good. Pressure, down, yes, good boy, that's right. Very good. After you do a few repetitions, sometimes you need to reward the dog for the sit and for waiting for the signal. That's a good boy. We've done pressure first and then the signal, so now we're going to do pressure with the signal and command. Down. Excellent boy. That's right. Good for you. Okay, let's try again. Sit. Good work. Ready? Down. Excellent boy. That's right. Very good. Okay, one more. Good job. Ready? Down. Very good. You can see that he starts to increase speed. That's a good boy. And then at that point, dismissed, you can start standing up. Phoenix, here. Sit. Okay, back. Sit. And see if you can teach the dog to obey that command while you're standing up, as well as the signal. I'm going to use my foot as a fulcrum in order to apply collar pressure. Notice that the heel is on the ground. I'm not going to do this. My hand is going to be the part moving the leash. Let's turn you around this way. Good boy. Sit. Excellent. Very good. So, again, pressure first. Down. Excellent boy. That's right. Good for you. Dismissed. That was good. Wait. Good. Pressure. Down. Excellent. That's a good boy. Very good. And as he gets better at that, dismissed, we go for speed. So this time I will apply the pressure as the signal happens. Down. Yay. That's a good boy. Very good. Okay. Dismissed. Good job. Here. Stay. Good. Down. That's a good boy. And then after he's learned to do the response correctly, I'm not going to worry about speed at the moment, but I want him to show me that he understands this. So I'm going to have the leash ready to apply pressure, but I'm going to give him a chance to obey. Down. Good boy. And if he hadn't moved within 1 second, I would have gone ahead and applied pressure and held it there until he hit the ground. If I have to do that, it's a message to me that he isn't quite ready to take responsibility, and we will stick with the first two steps, pressure before the command and pressure with the command, until he's had more experience with the idea that he can prevent or minimize that collar pressure by obeying the command. Okay, dismissed. Now, the same principle can be used for the recall after they've learned to stay. Sit. That's a good boy. And what I want to do is apply just a small amount of pressure toward me. I'm going to present the lure and ask him to come. Come. Very good boy. That's right. It is not my goal to move the dog with collar pressure. It is my goal to motivate the dog to move. Come. Yes. Good boy. And you could see him actually move forward as soon as he felt the pressure that time. So he understands what that means, that he should move in the direction of the pressure to turn it off. Good boy. Come. That time he moved before I could apply pressure. So it tells me that he really does understand the command. All right. Then you have to put the lures away and turn them into rewards, which is a critical aspect of training. So we go back to the very basic things they know. So we'll start with SIT. Sit. That's a good boy. And he did it without pressure, so that tells me that he actually understands the command, can praise, pet, and reward. That's a good boy. I'm going to show him there's no treats there. We're going to see if he understands the D-O-W-N. So I'm going to get my leash and collar ready. Phoenix, down. Yes, good boy. He didn't require any pressure, but my foot was ready so that I could use the leash to apply pressure if he had failed. Good job. All right, dismiss.